This video will show you the basics of how to format a paper based on APA 7th edition student version using Microsoft Word. All right, so the first thing let's do is let's add page numbers to this. Now you can't just type the number 1 on the first page and the number 2 on the second page. It'll overwrite them, it won't work right. But if you go up to the insert menu, it has an option for page numbers here. And we want them at the top right of the page, so we select that option, and it automatically numbers each page. Now this has done it in a different font than the rest of my paper. This is Arial, and the rest of my paper is in Times New Roman. So you can check with your instructor if you're supposed to use a particular font. APA isn't particular as long as it's professional looking like Times New Roman or Arial, but you do want it to be all the same font, so check that it doesn't do the page numbers a different font. The next thing you want is a title page. On your title page, you'll have your title in bold a few lines down from the top. Then you'll have an extra blank line, your name, your institutional affiliation, your college that you go to, the name of the course, your instructor, and the date for the assignment. Then you want to start the next page on a new page, right? So the easiest way to do that is to insert a page break. And you can do that here again from the insert menu, and it'll start a new page, and that'll stay where it's supposed to go. It'll float if you need to edit something, and it will stay there even if it's downloaded into a different software program that uses a different number of lines per page. Now, on this page, I've got my title again in bold and centered. Then I've got the rest of the paper typed up with indented paragraphs, double spacing, proper citations, and that sort of thing. When I'm ready for my reference page, I will again insert a page break to start that on a new page. The references heading is in bold. Mine says reference here because I only have one. Usually you'll have more than one. And then I want a hanging indent for my source. So you can highlight all your sources, and you can go back to the home ribbon, to the paragraph options, and click this little box where it says indentation and special, choose hanging and OK, and then it'll have a hanging indent. Okay, so that works a lot better than trying to tab it over, because Word messes everything up. If you've tried to do that, you'll understand that it doesn't work very well that way. Okay, so that should cover the basics of APA 7th edition format for a student paper in Microsoft Word. Thanks very much.